Hello everyone. Today we will discuss an important theorem, Fourier's theorem. This is my video on waves and oscillations. In the Fourier theorem, we shall learn what is the purpose of this theorem. See here. If you take an example of simple pendulum, what happens in simple pendulum? There is a bob. Bob, when displaced from equilibrium position on right side or left side, and if it is released, it oscillates. It oscillates about their mean position, means equilibrium position, means middle position. If we want to give the name of this oscillation, this is simple oscillatory motion. Now question is how to represent it. The simplest oscillatory motion, which we just I have given example of simple pendulum, is y is equal to a sin omega t or a cos omega t. This is the mathematical equation through which we represent the simple oscillatory motion. But sometimes, not sometimes, but many times we find the motion, or in wave and oscillations we get the vibration which is complex type. Not always simplest, not always simple oscillatory motion. Instead, we get the complex motion. So question is how to represent the complex vibration. As I told you, simplest oscillatory process that occurs in nature is described mathematically by a sin omega t or a cos omega t. But question is, if we have complex vibration, then how to represent? So let us first understand what is complex vibration. Where do we get the complex vibration? In day-to-day life, in everyday life experience, we experience or we see the alternating current, in which current varies from time to time, and not only its magnitude changes but also its direction changes also. So there is an oscillation type. Okay. If we talk about light, in which electric vector and magnetic field vector oscillates, or if we take an example of suppose music, and if any musical instrument is played, we get note. We call it fundamental note. But it is seen that the tone which we understand fundamental note is accompanied by overtones, tones, not tones. So it is also called a pure tone in the language of physics, music. Most of the sound that we hear are complex. They contain not only a fundamental tone, but also a number of overtones. Okay, so one fundamental tone and above, or in addition, there are so many overtones. It means here we can't represent fundamental tone plus additional overtones with the equation y is equal to a sin omega t or a cos omega t. Because this mathematical equation is meant for simplest oscillatory motion or simple oscillatory motion. Now, if the wave is complex, if the vibration is complex, if the oscillation is complex, then we write the complex or complicated function as a sum of terms corresponding to various harmonics. Harmonics. Overtone is also called harmonics. So fundamental tone plus additional overtones, that is harmonics. Fundamental tone plus harmonics. It will require an infinite series of terms containing all the harmonics in general. So finally, we can say that the complex vibration is represented by a sum of terms or infinite series of terms containing all the harmonics in general. And this series is called Fourier series on after the name of the discoverer. It is an expansion of a complex periodic function as a series of trigonometrical functions. Now we come to the topic Fourier's theorem. Up to now, you may conclude in two sentences. First, the simplest oscillatory motion is represented by the mathematical equation y is equal to a sin omega t or a cos omega t. Whereas, if the vibration is complex, it is represented by infinite series of terms containing all the harmonics, so known as Fourier series. Now, what is Fourier's theorem? Let us see its statement. What it states? It states that any continuous single valued periodic function can be expressed as a summation of simple harmonic terms having frequencies which are multiples of the frequency of the given function. Okay, this is the part of the statement. Now, what is continuous? What is single valued? What is periodic? Because its statement starts by any continuous single valued periodic function. See here. Continuous means there is no gap, no any gap. Once the wave propagates, starts, travels, it remains continuous. Single valued means at any point the displacement has only one value, not more than one. So one point means one value, known as single value. Periodic function means which is repeated in equal interval of time. So any motion, any vibration, any oscillation which is repeated in fixed interval of time is known as periodic motion. For example, in a simple pendulum, if one oscillation is completed or every oscillation is completed in equal time, then it is called periodic. Now, as I told you, the complex vibration is represented by the sum of series C here. Y is equal to, y is the displacement, and let its periodic function y is equal to f omega t here. So how to write mathematically y is equal to f omega t? Here a0 plus summation, the term containing constant an, the term containing constant bn. So one is cosine term, other is sine term. This is the Fourier theorem. If we elaborate it, we can write a0 and this term, an cos n omega t, may be written as a1 cos omega t, a2 cos 2 omega t, a3 cos 3 omega t, a lastly an cos n omega t, and simply similarly b1 sin omega t, b2 sin 2 omega t, and in at last bn sin n omega t. Here there will be plus sign missing, here plus sign will be here, so we have to correct it. Thus, this series is known as Fourier series. Why is the displacement? And A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, Bn, these are the cosine component and sine component of amplitudes. And multiple, these are the multiple of omega by 2 pi. A0 is a constant. Now, see here. This term, first term A0, it has its own meaning. Yes, A0 is a constant, but what type of constant? What it represents? It represents the displacement of the axis of the vibration. Okay? From the axis of the coordinate. Now, if we want to apply this theorem, if we want to apply this theorem to any complex vibration, for example, sawtooth wave, rectangular wave, square wave, and there are many different type of waves. So if we analyze any complex vibration using Fourier's theorem, then our duty is to first calculate these three things. What are these? These are A0, An and Bn. So see here, this one, A0, An, Bn. So whenever we want to use this theorem, we want to apply this theorem to analyze any complex vibration, for example, in sawtooth wave, in square wave, in rectangular wave, in triangular wave, we must have the we must know A0, An, Bn. We should know, get this value. We should know this value. A0, An, Bn. Okay. So let us get these values one by one. So how to get A0? There is a simple mathematical solution. I think you have any problem because you are familiar with simple calculus, differentiation, integration, preliminary knowledge, and simple mathematical calculation. So I think you can understand easily. See here, only you have to know the process, how to get, how to proceed. So how to get A0? Again, I come to the theorem. This is the theorem Y is equal to this one, equation one. So what we do? To get A0, we multiply equation by dt. So each and every term is multiplied by dt and integrate from 0 to t. Okay? What we do? Again, I repeat. We have to multiply equation 1 by dt and integrate from 0 to t. See here, first step 0 to t, y dt, 0 to t. So you can see. And one thing is interesting here, the term. This is your first term. You can see this is your first term. Okay. Only this term is under integration, and the rest integration of the rest term is zero. Okay. If you integrate these terms, you will get its value zero. So we put zero here, and the term left, the terms left are 0 to t y dt here and a0 dt, as a zero is constant, and integration of dt is t, and its maximum limit is t, upper limit is t, so it is a zero t. Now right side a zero t, and left side this one. So a zero is equal to what? A zero is equal to this one. I think you understand this part. Okay. So now we are in a position to know the value of a zero, 1/T0 to t y dt. You have to remember this to apply this theorem to any particular problem. We have to use this one. Next, which we are going to find is an. So to calculate an, again we use the equation one. Integrate every term from 0 to t and multiply each term by cos n omega t. You can see after multiplication and integrate using integration sign. See here, this term I am indicating. Okay, the term, this one, b1, bn coefficient, these are zero. So we will integrate only this term. See here, this one, because these are zero. And if we integrate this term, it will give the value of first term, second term, third term, and the terms containing coefficient b all are zero. Here I have written other terms are zero. And see here, this is an cos n omega t, cos n omega t, multiply cos square n omega t. And we use the formula, it is 1 plus cos 2 n omega t by 2, and 2 is taken outside, an is constant, so it is written here, outside integration, and now resolve bracket, 1 into dt, and cos 2 n omega t dt, this one, and this is again 0. So the term under integration, only this one, whose integration is t. So an is equal to an t by 2. Now an is equal to what? T by 2 is taken left side, this one. So first we got a 0, now we got an, and lastly we are going to find the value of bn. We will proceed similar in the same fashion, similar way as I proceed previously. Here the term containing coefficient a multiplied by cos n omega t, now we will multiply by sin n omega t, see here. And we will proceed in the similar way, and we get this one, bn. So now we got the value of a0, an, bn. Again, I am repeating, a0, an, bn, these are the coefficients, Fourier coefficients. And these are very important, because using these coefficients, we will apply Fourier's theorem to analyze a complex vibration, which we will discuss in the next video. Now, in the last, we are going to discuss Fourier's theorem limitations. As I told you, this is theorem is very important to analyze and synthesize the complex vibration. But this theorem has limitation also. There are two limitations. First limitation, that waveform must be continuous. There should be no any breaking, no any gap. And the displacement at any point must have only one value. As I told you in the earlier of this video, that single valued or one value means at any point one value. Displacement has only one value, not more than this. To for better understanding, for your convenience, I have taken here a graph, displacement versus time. You can see at point C, there are two values. One is here, other is here. It is not possible. If this happens, Fourier theorem will not be applicable. As Fourier theorem, limitation of Fourier theorem is, one of the limitation is, it the displacement should be single value. It means it must have only one value, not two. So it should not happen. Okay? And second, displacement must be finite. It must not have infinite. For better understanding, you can see here at point D, this line goes appears to go to infinity. If this happens, Fourier's theorem is not applicable. So Fourier's theorem has a limitation that the displacement must be finite, not infinite. It must have no any. It must have finite value, no any infinite value. Okay, so these two are not in agreement with the limit Fourier's theorem. Okay, I think you understood this video. Okay, thank you.